Federal Labor member for the seat of Chifley in Western Sydney is Ed Husic, and he joins me now. Ed Husic, welcome.
Thank you for having me on, Helen.
Now, the unfolding flood disaster, does the government have any firm idea yet of the damage bill from these floods, let alone the bushfires?
Well, the damage bill at this stage will be hard to total just because we are in an active event where, you know, there are still about 160,000 or close to 200,000 people without power, about 4,000 homes that could be affected by flooding, 2,000 businesses. There are a lot of roads that have been cut off, and so at this point in time, we won't be able to have a clear or concrete estimate, but everyone's obviously going to be keeping a close eye, not just on the property element, but also on the people side and hoping that people remain safe. So it's a very big concern. But we've kicked in some assistance measures already. They've started to go in under our national disaster relief and recovery arrangements. And so about close to 35 local government areas are already, you know, potentially able to access various arrangements under that.
Will the Prime Minister want to impose another flood levy after you introduced one 2 years ago for Queensland mainly?
Well, I think it's too early at this stage to speculate about it because, as I said, we're going through this active event. I think we'll just have to wait and see what occurs. I don't think really now is the time for politics.
Well, it is going
to
have a major hit to the budget, which the Treasurer confirmed today. So, in a sense, wouldn't that help to pay for the relief effort, pay for support to families who are going to need it?
Well, from my perspective, I had absolutely no problem supporting the flood levy in the aftermath of Cyclone Yasi. We needed to be able to gather together a huge amount of funds to be able to help Queensland recover. But at this point in time, where we're still trying to go through and help people at this critical point, you know, it's really just too early, Helen, for us to be able to say concretely that that does or doesn't have to occur. But we'll be guided by the experts, we'll be guided by the advice we get out of the Queensland government about the scale of the damage, and decisions will be made down the track, but it's just speculation at this point.
All right. Well, the start of the political year, in a way, has been put on hold because of the unfolding natural disasters. But Tony Abbott did begin his mini campaign yesterday. He had his mini launch. He had it in your neck of the woods in Western Sydney. Has he stolen a bit of a march on Labor by starting looking like he's a bit presidential? It was that sort of style launch yesterday, that he is on the move, that he is offering voters something?
Well, he's got a lot of work to do to try and convince people. He's saying that he wants to now be positive and recast himself, and he's got a heck of a lot of work to do to try and do that, and so he's trying to basically loosen off all that baggage that he's carrying, but I don't think that he'll be able to, frankly. He can't. It's in his DNA to be negative. You've seen some of that today, where at a point where he should be, basically, as we all should be, ditching the politics and helping people in their time of need, and already speculating in terms of the flood levelling and what may or may not occur. Whenever he's tested, he can't avoid the politics. And in terms of yesterday,
you're not avoiding the politics right now. You're still calling him Mr. Negative.
He is, though.
But in a sense, could he sidestep your portrayal of him as Mr. No, 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 which is what he's trying to do with that mini launch yesterday?
He can't sidestep because he keeps tripping over his own feet. I mean, we don't really have to do much because he will go back to form. And I mean, he launched a policy document yesterday, Helen, Real Solutions, that, you know, you would think a document titled like that would actually have real solutions, no new policies, fudging on other key points where they'd been beating their chest before, and don't really have anything concrete to be able to offer people and in particular, you referenced our region, Western Sydney. He doesn't really have anything positive that he can demonstrate to the people of Western Sydney that he'll be able to do.
All right, well, let's turn to your side of politics. I mean, Tony Abbott was in your neck of the woods, Western Sydney. This is a serious Achilles heel for you. Your seat of Chifley might be quite safe, but Greenway, Lindsay, David Bradbury there, they're in quite serious potential trouble, aren't they?
Well, I don't take and haven't from day one anything for granted. Like, it's a matter for all MPs to work hard on the ground representing their communities. Western Sydney, 1.6 million people, will continue to grow. When you look at what's happening in the northwest growth centres, southwest growth centre, you've got a city the size of Canberra expected to be put in there. So services, infrastructure, really important. The Liberals do not have, if you look in the New South Wales government, where they've cut school funding, where you can't even get simple infrastructure like lifts at railway stations. They've cut health funding this week in Western Sydney, $19 million. And basically, with the federal Liberals saying they want to cut spending by $70 billion, They need to not put out the glossy documents like they did yesterday that tell us nothing. They have to actually show Western Sydney what are they going to do.
But Ed Husic, if I could just be very blunt here, I mean, the reality is that five of your most marginal seats are in Western Sydney. Mm-hmm. You could lose them very easily. The New South Wales election showed that the Liberals have been on the rise. Why isn't this a major weak point for you?
Well, if you look at taking that very point, Helen, I'm glad you made reference to it. You know, there were a lot of people that voted Liberal at the last state election because they were dissatisfied with Labor and they gave us a kick in the back seat. Rightly so. But when they vote Liberal, they don't expect that they'll see their school funding cut. They don't expect that they'll have health funding cut. And in the case of Western Sydney, what I can look forward to now, I mean, Joe Hockey yesterday referred to Western Sydney as Liberal heartland, but they're about to dump radioactive waste in Western Sydney and move aircraft noise out to Western Sydney, with Joe Hockey declaring that they will build Badgerys Creek. These are key issues in this election this year, and the Liberals do need to declare where they stand on other issues before people go to vote.
All right, I just need to move on to your side of politics. I mean, the polls probably have been a bit kinder to the Prime Minister over the last few months, but her judgment has been severely questioned over the captain's pick, as she put it, of Nova Peris into sort of parachuting her straight into Parliament. I mean, it looks like the star system again at work, which really has ended in tears before for Labor.
Well, I think it's important that we're able to have an Indigenous representative representing the ALP in federal parliament.
But is it the way the Prime Minister handled this that has come to bite her back?
Look, I haven't seen evidence of that in terms of biting back yet. You'll see that you know, we'll go through the process of pre-selection the next day or so. You know, from my perspective, I would have preferred particularly in terms of, you know, Trish Crossan wants to have a say, and there'll be others that wanted to have a go at the pre-selection themselves. They wanted to go through that process. But, you know, as the Prime Minister said, she's exercised a choice, and I think it's an important choice when you look at the fact that we do, and it's really good to have, an Indigenous representative, particularly in the Labor side of politics in federal parliament.
So will the Prime Minister be able to sort of gather the forces together and they'll all be at one on this?
Well, I think on a whole host of issues we'll be focused on basically being able to best represent Labor, particularly, you know, for the focus of some of our discussion tonight in Western Sydney, and making sure that people are looked after, and I think you'll see evidence of that occur. I mean, as I said, we have on our side of politics, we've got runs on the board in terms of education, health, the type of things that are necessary for Western Sydney. On the other side of politics, all they've been able to show is cutting jobs, services and infrastructure, and I think that will be the focus leading into the months ahead, particularly for us out here.
All right, Ed Husic, we will have to leave it there, but hopefully we'll talk to you again through the year.
I hope so, and thanks for having me on.
Pleasure. It will be a big year.
It will.
Thank you. Our panel is next.